Bohr's model of atom. In this module, you will learn about the Bohr's model of an atom. There were number of scientists who were working on the structure of atom. Rutherford was one of them, and his model was the closest model to the Bohr model of the atom. In fact, Niels Bohr had helped to overcome the problem in the Rutherford's model of an atom. Rutherford's model of an atom had a major drawback that it could not explain the stability. It showed that electrons in an atom revolve around a positively charged center called nucleus. However, later on it was found that any particle in a circular motion would undergo acceleration and this electron loses energy. So the electrons would take a spiral path and would finally fall into the nucleus and the atom would collapse. But that does not take place in reality. Bohr said that electrons do revolve around the nucleus, but the energy remains fixed. He explained the energy of the electron remain fixed because they are restricted some fixed orbits. Each of its orbit is at a fixed distance from the nucleus and is associated with a fixed amount of energy. These orbits with a fixed amount of energy are known as discrete orbits or energy levels. These energy levels are represented by the letter K, L, M, N or the number 1, 2, 3, 4 starting from the center. So the final model of Niels Bohr similar to the Rutherford model of an atom which states the atom are positively charged center around which the electron revolve. The only difference was the Bohr model electron revolve around the nucleus and fixed orbit with fixed energy. For this work and his structure of atom, he got a Nobel Prize in 1922. Let's recap. Bohr model of atom suggested that an atom consists of a positively charged nucleus and the electrons revolve around it in special orbits called discrete orbits or energy levels. The energy of the discrete orbits remains fixed. These energy levels are represented by 1, 2, 3, 4 or K, L, M, N starting from the center. Bohr got the Nobel Prize for his work in 1922.